after we have organized the data in a table, the next thing that we need to do is to summarize in the data. So how to summarize the data? So it depends on the type of the data. If the data type is an ordinal or nominal data type, so usually we're going to use a table to summarize the frequency for each of the category. If the data type is the scale data, so usually we use the chart, okay, to plot the data on a chart. So this is an example. So these are the chart that you are familiar. For example, the bar chart, pie chart, histogram, scatter plot, and also the box plot. Okay. So these are the chart that we are frequently used in the data analysis to summarize our data. So we can use the data that we organized just now. So for example, if you want to plot the value of the highlight, the data of the highlight in terms of the length, so we can plot each of the data by using the bar chart. Okay. However, this is may not be the most meaningful chart that you might want to use. And for example, for the ordinal data, what we can do, we can plot it as is in the bar chart as well. So in the scale data, so we can plot each of these as one unit in S axis, and then map each of this bar according to the value, okay, the scale value. On the other hand, for the data that you collected as a nominal or ordinal data, you cannot plot the value of this category directly. So what we need to do, usually we need to first summarize it in the table. Okay. And then for each of these category, we just count the number of the exponent unit with this variable. So in this case, this is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4. And the other character also 4. Then after that, we can plot a bar chart, which each, the x-axis represent each of these category, and then plot the frequency. Similarly, for the nominal data, so we can summarize it in the bar chart or in a pie chart. So before we can construct the chart, it's very important that we need to summarize the data in a frequency table. So you have species 1, 2, 3, and then just count the frequency. And then based on this, you can calculate the percentage rate which you need to use to construct a pie chart. And sometimes we are not only want to explore the data, we also want to examine the few of this variable at the same time. For example, in this case, we want to investigate, is there any relationship between the high leg and also the four leg length? So the most useful chart that we use is the scatter plot. So in this case, we have two axes, S and Y, and each of these axes is represent each of these variables. Okay. So for each of these point represent an S-band unit. So we have species 1, lizard 1. So the value of the highlight is 5, the foreleg is 20. So since we have two variables, S and Y, we can use the value for each of these variables as a S and Y coordinate, and then put the dot according to the S and Y value. So this is our first dot, the lizard 1. So we can plot each of these S-band unit in the chart, okay, according to S and Y axis. So this is the plot that we use to examine the relationship between two variables. So there is another plot we can use to explore the data, for example, a box plot. So for box plot, we need to calculate a few key variables or the value which you can use to make a box plot. So first we need to calculate the median or the second quarter, Then after that, we need to calculate the first quartile, the quartile. Then we need to calculate the interquartile range. The next step is to identify the outlier, if there are any outlier. And then identify the maximum and also the minimum value from the data set. So we can plot the data to explore the distribution of the data, or we can plot the data according to different groups or treatments or category. In this case, it's the differences between the four leg length and also the high leg length. After you know how to make different charts, so which chart should be used for what kind of the research question and for what kind of or what type of the data. So it really depends on the research questions, whether your question is about differences, association, relationship, or group or patterns. So it depends also on the data type, whether it's scale, ordinal, or nominal.